I'm going to try something new between now and the end of the year. Rather than doing one mailbag a month, approximately, and doing a bunch of different things, I'm going to do a Monday mailbag every Monday from now, which is the middle of November, until the end of the year. And I'm going to restrict myself to 4 or 5 per mailbag. That way I don't run out of stuff to show you. So, if everybody's cool with that, got yourself a fresh drink, let's get into her. It's mailbag time. Let's start with this one. It says it's electronic parts. So let's see what kind of electronic parts it is, because I'm pretty confident that it's electronic parts. It's always electronic parts. Well, almost always. What do we got here in the static bag? Whoa! Ah, it is a resistance substitution board. That's cool. That's completely different than the one that I used to carry in my test kit years ago. So, what this is for is when you're trying to experimentally determine a component value, or trying to identify what value you need exactly, you could, of course, use a potentiometer, a variable resistor. But you could also use, but then you've got to measure it afterwards and try and find something close. This one, you hook up to your circuit on these two pins over here, and then you move the jumpers around to change the resistance. What's going on inside here is each set of 10 just adds another resistor in series, a bunch of surface mount resistors. So the 1 or times 1 ohm times 10 ohm times 100 ohm times 1000 ohms, 10, 100, K, and 1 meg. So each one of these has a stack of resistors here. So these will be all 1 ohm resistors. These will be all 10 ohm resistors. These will be all 100 ohm resistors. All the way up, these are all 1 meg resistors. And then each column is in series. So right now, with the way it came out of the box, with the jumpers all sitting in the 4, you have 4,444. So 444,444 ohms. If we were to put a meter on that, grab the one that's on top of the pile, this should come up fairly close to all 4s. Let's just see. Try not to get my hand in the circuit, but that count away. Yeah, come on. Okay, I don't have the digits of precision, but that's pretty close to 4.44444 meg. And you can just move these jumpers around to wherever you want them to be. Because I've got massive fingers, I'm going to use tweezers. Excuse me. Reach around here. And you just move them around. So if I put them all up to zeros, like that, and if I put them all up at zeros all the way around, it would basically be a dead short across there. I'm going to do that. I'm just going to pause and change it and be right back. Okay, there we are with all of the jumpers in the zero position. And that should show pretty much a dead short, and it does. A third of an ohm, depending on how I hold these in there. That's pretty close. What is... That's pretty darn close to nothing. Now then, if I flip them all up to the maximum, it's going to be pretty close. It's going to be 1 ohm away from 10 meg. I'll just quickly do that. All right. Oops, I missed one. I would have been 10 ohms out, which is beyond the precision of my meter anyway, probably for at the high range, but whatever. So here we go. Now this should be pretty much 10 meg once it settles down. There we go. Cool. Now then, this isn't super duper useful in digital circuitry, but in analog, if you're making audio amplifier circuits or stuff like that, or actually, if you're messing around with 555s and you want to find an optimum resistor value, again, you could breadboard it up with a potentiometer in it, like I did with this one. Or you could just put the substitution board in there to figure out what you want this resistor to be to get the speed of oscillation you want. So that's a pretty cool little tool to have. 1R to 999999, etc. R, 7-decade programmable resistors board. Step 1R, 1% half watt. The resistance substitution board, all based on surface mount resistors. I bought this one from Alice 110-1983, and oh, it looks like there's a price drop. I bought it a few months back for $6.29, according to my notes, and at the moment, it seems to be selling for $5.73 Canadian, so that's a even better deal. Free economy international shipping, yes, of course it is. And what else do we have down here about it? Same thing again. Good for experiments, engineering design, test trimming. Yep, that's pretty much what I thought. FR4 glass fiber PCB. Maximum working voltage, 200 volts. That seems optimistic. Especially for as close as everything's packed on there. Plus with all the exposed pins and whatnot, I don't really think I'd want that kind of voltage on it. And 5 volts up to like 25 or even 50 volts, I'd be more than comfortable with that. But once we start getting into the hundreds, no, I don't think that's a good idea. All right, next up, we have, what is it? Electronic components, it says in there. All right, well, let's see what it is. Sometimes they get creative on these descriptions. Sometimes they flat out lie, and sometimes it's just the most generic in the world. Oh, that looks like a wee Arduino of some kind. Okay, it says SS Micro on it, and the pins are all labeled, but other than that, there's not a lot of clues. It's in the form factor, or similar form factor, to this little guy, the DigiSpark, which is based on the ATtiny. But what it really is in the Leonardo family, similar to this Pro Mini, not to be confused with the Pro Micro. No, wait, hang on. No, it's Pro Micro. That's the Pro Micro in the Leonardo family. The Pro Mini is this guy back here, which is more in the Uno family and the Nano family. So these guys run on a slightly different chip, which, can we read it here? So these guys, instead of running on the ATmega328 platform, they are on the Atmel Mega32U4. The difference being, these guys have a built-in USB interface right in the chip. Importantly for my tinkering around, these guys can be a USB human interface device, like a keyboard or a mouse, or at least they can emulate one, and do that based on the pin inputs. And I was originally tinkering around with one of those. Where is it here? There it is. This one. When I was connecting it up to an NES controller, which is buried somewhere in here. Hang on. There it is. So my ultimate plan, which I haven't gotten around to yet, I've got the hardware kind of figured out and sort of working. There's a video about that a ways back. I've got a bunch of code that needs to be written in there, and I suck at code, so I've been trying to control my teenager into doing it, but he's got much more critical teenager things to do. Don't know what those are. Can't remember. It's been decades since I've been a teenager. Anyway, eventually I'll get back to that, but in the meantime, I've got a couple more of these guys in the Leonardo family that I can play with or use to expand that. Excellent. Arduino Beetle USB ATmega 32U4 Mini Development Board Module Leonardo RR3. Okay, I got this one from GoWin Electronic, and I paid $6.78, but since then it looks like the price has snuck up a little bit. All these things, the prices just move around on a weekly basis. I mean, what I paid for it, what it costs today, is probably not what you would pay for it when you watch this video a couple of days later. Regardless, it's under $10 for something this powerful. That's grand. Where did I get before I got sidetracked? GoWin Electronic. Free shipping, yes. And yeah, that's the name I was searching for. I was Arduino Beetle, which is a relatively new form factor and board. It does the 3.3. Oh yeah, it is internally 3.3 volts, like all the Leonardo family is. So it's got a regulator on the back, which is pulling power from the USB, or you can power it from the side here if you want. And yeah, it's got 1, 2, 3 analog, 4 analog, 5 analog, or some of them can also do double duty as a digital pin. And so it's not got quite as many pins available as a full-blown Leonardo or the Pro Mini, but the form factor makes it cool to experiment with. You can just put it straight into a USB port, and as I said, in addition to doing all normal Arduino-y kind of stuff, these ones can emulate a keyboard or a mouse or a game controller and things like that, which is, I think, where the real power of this device and the cool factor of this device comes from. Okay, the next thing. Component times one. That seems highly descriptive. Could be anything. Oh, in this case, it actually is components, not modules or anything. Cool. It is a bunch of capacitors, 2 kilovolt. 102K to 681K, 10 pieces of each. At least I'm guessing what those things in between the Chinese digits mean. So yeah, just a bunch of ceramic capacitors. I've got an assortment of other capacitors. Hang on. That are electrolytics of various values, but for the different range of values, the higher lower capacitance and non-polarized activities or higher voltages, there's a bunch of ceramics to fill out the collection. 100 pieces, 10 values, so 10 pieces of each. 102K, 681K range, 2kV high voltage ceramic capacitors kit assortment from Chip Partner. I paid $3.04 Canadian, or if you happen to prefer American dollars, $2.37. Free shipping from China/Hong Kong/Taiwan. And again, lots of other sellers selling lots of other similar things. And the last one for my mini Monday mailbag. This is kit quantity one. Well, That's not performance. What do we got in here? Audio connectors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3.5 millimeter, 4 conductor. Okay. Those are just replacement parts. 4 conductor are the ones that go into the headphone jack on your smartphone. And the 4th conductor is that one, I think, is the 4th one, is the microphone. So you got the ground or return or common. Tip and ring are the left and right audio, and I can't remember which one's which. And then that must be the microphone for the 4th one. Just another handy thing to have in stock in the repair shop, just in case. 5 pieces, 3.5 millimeter plug connector, male stereo audio, metal 1/8 inch jack, solder terminal. Yes, the solder type, because that's nice and solid, and I'm not scared of soldering. Got them from Tool-Edge, who I don't think I've ever ordered from before. They're listing at $4.22. I think they were a little bit less when I ordered them, but not too much less. As usual, free shipping. And there's not that much to say about them that hasn't already been said. 4-pole, 3.5 millimeter, all metal. Nice and rugged and durable, hopefully. And there we go. There's today's Mailbag Monday haul. I'll talk to you next week with 4 or 5 more things out of my mailbag. If you give me a comment down below what you think of me changing it up like this for the rest of the month or the rest of the year, the next 6 weeks or so. Do you like this, or do you want me to go back to a little bit more in depth with more pieces once a month? Yeah, leave a comment below either way. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.